The world is watching, watching China's century-long quest. The world is listening, listening to China's 100-year story. The world is talking, talking about China's century of great change. With deep-set eyes and a hybrid nose, this 69-year-old man speaks the Beijing dialect fluently. He is the first child of Erwin Engst, known as YangZao in China, and Joan Hinton, or Han Chun, who arrived in China from the US in the 1940s. The two came to China to support agricultural development. He was named Yang He Ping, which means peace in Chinese. For more than 60 years, Yang He Ping's parents devoted themselves to improving the quality of dairy herds and mechanizing dairy farms in China. At an agricultural machinery testing site in Changping in the suburbs of Beijing, everyone knows Yang He Ping, as his parents transformed this place into a dairy farm in the
1980s.
About 5-6 years, they're able to become the best herd in Beijing. And then you have people around the country come to visit and see a success story and demonstrating and copying and giving the blueprint free to people around the country. That was a great contribution to the dairy industry in China.
Before coming to China, Yang He Ping's mother, Han Chun, was a student of Enrique Fermi, a Nobel laureate in physics. She worked on the Manhattan Project to develop the atomic bomb. However, when the US dropped atomic bombs on Japan in 1945, Han Chun was shocked and quit the project. Influenced by the book Red Star Over China, she determined to go to China.
For my mother, she's interested in science and technology, and she feel in China she can really contribute a great deal. So she spent most of her life in China doing agricultural machinery, dairy machinery, and doing the projects that she found interesting and also important, is useful. My father is always interested in animal husbandry, raising cows. Both of them spend their life in China doing what they think is worthwhile, interesting, and valuable.
In his 20s, out of curiosity, Yang He Ping chose to leave China and study in the United States, where he got married and had children. However, he found himself confused. Everything seemed upside down, and he couldn't tell right from wrong.
Confused, very confused. And so I thought I should go to college and try to get some education, maybe help me understand what's going on. It didn't help. And then I went to graduate school.
None of this helped. The longer Yang stayed in the United States, the more depressed and homesick he became.
I find myself observe what's going on in China a lot more than what I observe what's going on in the US. Even though I would live in the U.S., I just find the development in China really touched my heart. My childhood friends, my colleagues in China, and all the events in China is what I care the most. That's the main reason why I eventually decided to come back.
When Yang He Ping returned to China in 2007, he felt calmer than he had ever felt before. He had finally found the conviction to support himself. He is also happy that China is getting better and better.
And these last dozen years has been the greatest in my life. And now China getting is a rapidly developing industrial power, the bullet train network, And that, that really impressed not only the Westerners, it impressed Chinese too.
Now living in China and teaching at a university, Yang not only shares stories of China with overseas students, but also talks about his parents and the history and culture of China to his own children and future generations.
I bring my kids to the China many times, and they love this place, and they are very fond of my grandparents. And they're also interested in Chinese history, Chinese culture, and all that. They grew up watching Donald Ducks, but I also teach them Monkey King stories.